إن الحمد لله أحمده تعالى واستعين به واستغفره واستهديه وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Dear respected brothers, mashallah, we are going in the month of Ramadan fasting. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, may Allah accept from all of us. Ameen Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Yesterday in our journey to the hereafter, I was talking about the good ending or the good death for the Muslim and the sign of good ending. Today, I'm going to talk about the sign of a bad ending or bad death. I know most of us wouldn't like to talk about this because something will make us sad. But it's good to know, at least to avoid these things. there are too many bad deeds. If somebody will do it mostly in his life without repentance, these good deeds can cause him or lead him to the bad death or the bad ending. For example, if somebody is not praying, he's neglecting his salah, completely ignoring the prayer, the namaz, that person will have very bad ending, very bad death. And you can see these signs before his death. If somebody, he insists himself and he's still doing all this, all of his life, the same sin until he die, also that person will be punished. Somebody doing adultery or zina, he never stopped from doing that. If he dies, or he died while he's doing that, he will be punished in his grave. And also, and not just that, he will have very bad ending. Or somebody also drinking alcohol, intoxication or drunk, alcohol, khamr, without tawbah, that person also will have very bad death. Bad one. Or somebody singing or listening every day to the songs, especially these songs nowadays with like fake hypocrisy and nifaq and all of that stuff. These songs can lead him to the bad death, especially if he neglects the Quran al-Kareem. Because it's the songs, according to the Sheikh Abu Bakr al-Jazairi and his book Manhaj al-Muslim, he named the songs for the Quran and the Sunnah. He gave 11 names from the Quran, the Sunnah about the songs. It's haram. Especially the instruments. The tambur and the oud. Nowadays they call it tambur, tabla, all of this stuff. And we know that the duf is halal. And the song itself, I don't know what details, but just I don't want to change my subject. But if somebody listens to the songs and neglecting the Quran, this is a big, big problem. Because the song is Mazmur Shaitan, the Quran, Kalam al-Rahman. That's why you have to know all of this. Hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah, a Muslim, Hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah, he said, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa saying, يُبْعَثُ كُلُّ عَبْدٍ عَلَى مَا مَاتَ عَلَيْهِ. يُبْعَثُ كُلُّ عَبْدٍ عَلَى مَا مَاتَ عَلَيْهِ. If somebody doing Hajj, like what I said yesterday, and he died while he's doing Hajj, he will stand in the day of judgment while he's saying talbiyah, labbaik Allahumma labbaik. Somebody drink alcohol, subhanallah, and he die while he's the bottle of alcohol in his hand. He's gonna stand in the day of judgment while he's carrying this khamr in his hand. Yes, it's Allahu Akbar. Somebody die while he was making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's different. It's different. Subhanallah. Abu Huraira narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in that hadith, narrated by Imam Muslim also, authentic hadith. I will say it in English because of the time. He said, a man, indeed, you see a man, a long time in his life, he was making good deeds. And before his death, he made bad deed. And he ended his life with that bad deed, and he would enter his fire. And you see a man, all of his life, making bad deeds. And in the end, before the end of his life, he make good deed and he die while he's making good deed and he will enter Jannah. According to this hadith, what is this? Is that fair? Somebody all of his life making good deeds. And he was very close to the Jannah like this. Like Zira' 1 yard or Spain. And he make a bad deed. And he end his life with this bad deed and he enter hellfire. Is that fair? What do you think? The scholars, when they explained that hadith, they said the one who used to make good deeds all of his life, he used to make it for showing off, riyah. He was not sincere when he was doing these good deeds. But that man, which is he was making bad deeds during his life, somehow he did repent. He made tawbah. And when he made the tawbah, he was sincere. And he died with tawbah, with sincerity, and he entered Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will replace your bad deeds to good deeds. Subhanallah. فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا وَمَنْ تَابَ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَمَنْ تَابَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَإِنَّهُ يَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَتَابَ. If you make tawbah, repentance, and you follow your tawbah with righteous good deeds, this is what Allah loves from you. What you have to say? Muslim must say, oh Allah, our hearts between two of your fingers. Oh Allah, make our hearts steadfast and firm in your deen. Ya muqallib al-qulub thabbit qalbi ala deen. Today I'm coming to the masjid. Today I'm doing good deeds. Today I'm a good person. But tomorrow, my heart is going to change. Allahu Akbar. That's why Allah said in the Holy Quran, Inna Allah yahulu bayna al-mar'i wa qalbi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is sitting, or he is not, cannot say sitting, he is between you and your heart. If you make good deeds, Allah can replace your heart to be a good heart. Subhanallah, I can change it. This is what I mean. We have some of signs or some bad deeds can cause its person to have bad death or bad ending in his life, in the end of his life. Number one, الشك والجحود والتعبد بالبدع. If somebody he is in doubt or he has hatred to Islam, or that person he worship Allah with innovation. Because if you worship Allah with innovation, you're telling Rasulullah in different way, I don't like your way, let me have my own way. I'm gonna invent some kind of ibadat, let me follow what is better than you, O Muhammad. Astaghfirullah. This is a way, even if they cannot say it with their own tongue, but with their action, they say it. That's why you cannot invent anything in Islam. In Islam, قَالَ لَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, that's it, finish it. And also, if you have shak, doubt about Allah, doubt about Muhammad, doubt about your Quran, doubt about the grave, doubt about the hereafter, doubt about Jannah and hellfire, doubt about the day of reckoning, يوم القيامة, this is will cause its person to have bad death. That's why what you have to do, be certain. Certainty, حق يقين, علم يقين, عين يقين. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran. Also, number two, very fast because of the time, التسويف للتوبة. Somebody, if you ask him, brother, you are making sin. Brother, come back to Allah, make tawbah, ya akhi. He said, I will, I'm still young. Tomorrow. No, life is still long. This is shaitan, it's telling him, تسويف, you will not now, it's okay. Ya Am, come to the masjid. No, Ya Am, Sheikh, forget me, just a good hour. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت قال رب ارجعون. Sudden death. And when he die, he will ask Allah, oh Allah, I want to return, give me respite. I want to go back to the dunya to make good deeds. Allah say, Kalla, nay. Let him say whatever he want. إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ وَقِيلُ. But he can stay in his barzakh, in his grave, until the day of judgment. إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. There are too many ayats, but I want to go very fast because my time. Anybody, he's not making tawbah. Anybody disobeying Allah. Anybody, he just say sawfa, I will, not now. Subhanallah. And sudden death comes to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها. If somebody his time comes, Allah will not delay it. خلاص, you have to go. This is your time. This is your station. فابن كثير said كل مفرط يندم عند الاحتضار. Anybody مفرط, anybody has shortcomings during his time of death, he will regret. But his regret will not benefit him during that time. حيث لا ينفع الندم. Yes. Even those who used to make good deeds, they will regret. Why I did not increase my good deeds more than what I used to do. For everybody will regret. Subhanallah. Al-Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah, he said, hayhat, hayhat, ahlak al-nas al-amani. I said, most of the people being destroyed because of their false hope. Al-amani. Tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. I will. And he will find himself where? In the grave. Number three, one of the reasons of the punishment of the grave and the bad ending, bad death, that if people will be away from Sirat al-Mustaqim, if somebody will avoid Sirat al-Mustaqim, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 19 times every day in our prayer in Surah Al-Fatiha, اهدنا الصراط ليه؟ اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 19 times in our namaz prayer, oh Allah guide us to the straight path. That's why those who been supported, protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them firm during their lifetime and in the hereafter, المؤمنين الذين آمنوا, the believing women and men. Allah said in Surah Ibrahim, verse number 27, يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا ويضل الله الظالمين ويضل الله الظالمين ويفعل الله ما يشاء. Only Allah سبحانه وتعالى will make those who believe in His oneness, الذين آمنوا, with sincerity, with certainty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them firm during their time of death, thabat, and in the grave, they will say the kalima la ilaha illallah. Fi al-hayat al-dunya wa fi al-akhirah. During their time of death and in the akhirah, in the grave. Fa, ikhwani, but those who used to say our Lord Allah and they used to make good deeds, the malaika, the angels of mercy, will descend on them during their time of death and they will make them firm and they will tell them, don't be sad, don't worry about your present time, don't be sad about your past, and for the future they will give them glad tidings of al-Jannah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا وإياكم منهم. فلذلك we have to know that too many people, I told you, too many people, because they are not in the straight path, sometimes they come to the masjid, sometimes they make good deeds, but they are not firm, they are not strong enough. Why? And you see some of them, even they come to the masjid and after being mashallah good, they go vice versa, they go back, subhanallah, they used to be worse than before. الانتكاسة بعد الاستقامة. That's why we have to ask Allah to be in the straight path all the time, all the way to the end. You cannot return back. Like, you know why? I'll give you an example. Like those who used to come in Ramadan and after Ramadan they stopped coming to the masjid. Yeah, Sheikh, what bring at home? No, it's not enough. You know, to pray at home is not enough. There is a masjid. And salat, your prayer in the masjid 27 times more than your prayer at home or your market or in the wherever outside. That's why sometimes I said in America, I know we are in the Western society busy doing too many things. But what we have to do, at least the minimum, come for Fajr and Isha. There is no work during that time. During the daytime, I know you are working. You can fix yourself, no problem. But at least the minimum, come Salat al-Fajr and Salat al-Isha, Jama'ah. And Salat al-Jama'ah is very important. This is very important. Number four, these bad deeds or these things will cause people to have bad ending your a bad ending or bad death. طول الأمل. If somebody have like false hope, yeah, today I have long life, I'm still young, I'm healthy, I have business, I have money, I have power, I have everything. And the shaitan is giving him what? False hope. Live more, take more, carry more, do more, more and more. Forget الآخرة. اليوم الله يحلها الله. When we come to the day of judgment, Allah will help us. You know, it's okay, enjoy your life. And I'm not telling you don't enjoy your life. Enjoy your life, but in the right way. But take the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasulullah was telling Abdullah ibn Umar, كن في الدنيا كأنك غريب أو عبر سبيل. سيدنا عبد الله they used to say, إذا أصبحت فلا تنتظر المساء وإذا أمسيت فلا تنتظر الصباح. Means be in this dunya, the advice of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم to Abdullah ibn Umar, be in this dunya like what? A stranger, عابر سبيل, traveler. This is a way. Carry only that kind of load will help you not be against you. إحنا are مساكين, we misunderstand everything in our life, wallahi. Somebody barely, he can carry like 50 pound or 100 pound, 100 pound. And barely he will walk with this 100 pound. And he said, no, 100 pound is not, is nothing. I need 1,000 pound. 1,000? Ya akhi, you cannot walk with 100. Why you gonna carry 1,000? You ask for 1,000, why? This is exactly the seekers of the dunya. They wanna carry big load. طيب, I'm not saying anything. Wallahi, if you get it from halal and you become strong, alhamdulillah, that's good. It's not bad. But the problem is, most of people, they've been disturbed by dunya and they neglect the akhirah. This is my point. If you neglect your akhirah, this is a big problem, jama'ah. صلاح أول هذه الأمة بالزهد واليقين. You have to be certain. But if you will be stingy and have like false hope, this is the destruction, like what our scholar said. Ali ibn Abi Talib said, I am afraid of what? When you follow your desire and you have false hope, this is the destruction of these people. Why? Because if you follow your desire, you will never follow the right path, the truth, or the true thing. And طول الأمل, the false hope, will let you forget about your akhirah. ينسي الأخرة. Yes, because I have long life. Let me enjoy. I don't care about my akhirah now. That's it. This is what they say. And most of these people, because of their ignorance, الجاهل يا جماعة, الجاهل عدو نفسه. الجاهل, if you know, you recognize, like what Allah said in the Quran, Surah An-Nisa, we're going to recite it tonight, verse number 78, Allah said, أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة. Wherever you will be, death will come to you even if you put yourself inside a cage to protect yourself from that death. Death will come to you. I have too many stories, but subhanAllah, يعني there is no time to mention too many. Remember the story of Sayyidina Sulaiman, who was sitting in Palestine, and his wazir was sitting with him. The angel of death came to visit Sayyidina Sulaiman. And the angel of death was talking to Solomon. I'm very surprised. Allah asked me to take the soul of this man in India. Why he's still here? And the man, subhanAllah, the angel of death was looking at him and he scared him. He came as in the feature of a human being. He scared him. And that man, the wazir of Sulaiman, he said, my king Sulaiman, my Nabi, please ask the wind to carry me to India. I'm scared from this man. He escaped from Palestine to India from him. And he said, I'm very surprised why this man is here. He must be in India now to take his soul. Subhanallah. So that's why, يعني, أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة. Also, one of these bad things or can cause people to have bad death or a bad ending, حب الدنيا. حب الدنيا. The love of الدنيا, this worldly life so much. More you love الدنيا, more you will ignore الأخرة. Ignore الأخرة. You neglect your أخرة. Because if you love somebody or if you love something, you're going to work for it. If I love, I love الدنيا, if you attach your heart to الدنيا. This is the meaning. To attach your heart too much, you work just for الدنيا. You work just for الدنيا. You block الأخرة. I don't need الأخرة. Just my My whole issue, my aim is dunya. This is my point. And subhanAllah, those who loves dunya, they will be punished three times. Number one, because they're going to leave it. They're going to leave it dunya. This is some kind of punishment, especially if they have money or they have wealth or they have anything like this. Number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take them away from these things which they used to love. Also. And number three, in the hereafter, they will be punished for what they used to do during their lifetime. Why? Because of their love to dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Surah At-Tawbah, verse 55, فَلَا تُعْجِبُكَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ فَلَا تُعْجِبُكَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ بِهَا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَتَزْهَقَ أَنفُسُهُمْ وَهُمْ كَافِرُونَ سبحان الله. They are, Allah will punish them because of what they have. Imagine if somebody has money and power. His punishment will be in that money and that wealth. Somebody has too many kids and he was thinking, this is my power, my kids, my sons. Allah punish him with these kids. Imagine that. Like I said that before too many times. Money or wealth or dunya, like a snake in your hand. If you don't know how to control that snake, to carry it good, that snake will bite you up. You're going to be the first one will be beaten up from the snake. You have to handle it and control it from its head like this strongly. Otherwise, if you give him just a little bit like this, you're going to turn his head, money like this. Wallahi al-azim, wealth and power like that. Be careful. That's why, ya jama'a, it's so dangerous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it could be enemy, this enemy to you. We have to open our eyes to this. One of these signs also of a bad ending or bad death, like what we said, صحبت الأشرار, when you have very bad companionship. Your companionship will drag you. If you have good people, they will drag you to the masjid. They will drag you to the Jannah. If you forget, they will remind you. They will remind you. They will give you admonition all the time about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Akhirah. And the... Somehow, when you put yourself around these good people, Allah will send some kind of rahmah. Even if you are not good, you're going to get portion of this rahmah. But if you sit around the bad people, even if you are not bad, maybe Allah will punish them while you are there. Allah will take you too. واتقوا فتنة لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة واعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب. The fitna, when the fitna here means punishment. Protect yourself from the punishment of Allah can come to everybody, good and bad. That's why don't sit around the bad people. And Rasulullah gave us good example about the bad people, like the blacksmith. When you sit with around the blacksmith, bad smell or you're gonna burn your clothes. Even if he will not burn your clothes, you're going to get that smell from him. This is the bad companionship. Al-mar'u yuhsharu ma'a man ahab. Rasul said, anta ma'a man ahbabt. Hadith Hassan wa rawahu Abu Dawud. But that's why, very important, jama'a. You see, Abu Talib, the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, during his time of death. Rasulullah standing in one side of him. And Abu Jahl, Udba, Shaybara, Rabi'a, Al-Kharbanin, بتوع مكة دول, شلة الصيع دول, أنا سام شلة الصيع بتوع مكة دول. They were standing around Abu Talib. Rasulullah saying, يا Abu Talib, يا عمي, say لا إله إلا الله, just say it, that's all. And they say, Abu Jahl, أوعى, no. And Rasulullah السلام saying again, عمي, please, uncle, say لا إله إلا الله, please say لا إله إلا الله. Rasulullah was begging him, and these Kharbanin around him, Abu Talib, Dalek, Abdul Muttalib, okay. They did not say okay, of course. Malaki Mecca. Allah. What happened? Abu Talib said, I will die in the way of Abdul Muttalib, his dad. He did not listen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah was crying a lot for his uncle because Abu Talib used to support Rasulullah all of his life. And he used to love him. He grew him up. So he grew up in his house. Subhanallah. And Allah told the Rasulullah, listen, ya Muhammad, innaka la tahdi man ahbabt, walakin Allah yahdi man yasha. You cannot guide whom you will. But Allah, the one who guides. Allah, the guidance in the hand of Allah. Same thing with the father of سيدنا إبراهيم. سيدنا الله, سيدنا نوح with his son, with his wife, Lot with his wife. See? We have to be, يا جماعة, careful. Your friend can drag you إذا جريت في خلق دنية على الجارمة كده. فأنت ومن تجاريه سواء. رأيت الحر يجتنب المخازي ويحميه عن الغدر الوفاء. Your friend can drag you to the Jannah or to the hellfire. فبي careful يا جماعة الخير. Also if somebody منافق, he hides something and he do something else, that person will have, if he did not make tawbah, he will have a bad ending, bad death. فthat's why very important. يستخفون من الناس ولا يستخفون من الله ومعهم. Allah talk about the hypocrite or hypocrisy. فالله said كمثل الشيطان إذ قال الإنسان اكفر. فمهم جدا يا جماعة to attach your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Attach your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you have to avoid this kind of hypocrisy. Be away from it. Number 9, su' al-dhan. If you have bad thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Somebody is telling you, I make a lot of sin in my life. Allah will never forgive me. Why you say that? Do not belittle the rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you compare it with your sins. Allah Rahim, Allah Kareem, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, sisters, the brothers, very important. Also, that thing will cause you to a bad ending, al-israr ala dhunub wal-ma'as, if you continue making the same sin you are doing all of your life. Somebody addicted to the sin. Maybe you see somebody 78 years and he's doing the same sin since he was 15. Allahu Akbar. Since he was 15 or 20. Now you became 80 or 70, you're doing the same sin. When you gonna stop? When you gonna stop? After your death? لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. That's why الإصرار على الذنوب والمعاصي can cause the person to have very bad ending. Very bad ending, سبحان الله. And also if you forget about الآخرة, the hereafter, القيامة, the day of reckoning, يوم الحساب, and you don't want to remember even the death. Yes, remember death. Death will soften your heart. When you remember death, you remember when you're going to stand before Allah Azza wa Jal, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you. That's why when you remember death and you remember al-akhirah, you will never be lazy when you come to the masjid. Yes, let me work for my hereafter. Why I have to be lazy? Allah will count me for this prayer. Why I have to be lazy? Let me do my namaz. Let me do my salah. Let me fast, let me obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very important, ya jama'a. If you remember al-akhirah, you will make good deeds, wallahi. If you remember the grave, you will make good deeds that will give you courage to worship Allah more, and you're gonna recognize your life is very short. Somehow, you will go and you will die, and suddenly you will be in the grave and Allah will ask you. You will face the trials of the grave, the trials of fitnat al-qabr, and all of this stuff. Number 12, الظلم. Don't be unjust. Don't oppress anybody. Don't backbite. Don't slander people. Don't take their rights. If somebody working for you, don't take his money. If somebody dealing with you with business, don't oppress him. You know, don't oppress your wife, your kids. Be just, because Allah is just, subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you will not do that, that will cause you, if you will be unjust, to have a bad ending, bad death. There are too many ahadith. Even during your lifetime in dunya, Allah will punish you, especially if you oppress somebody. Said in the hadith here, number 2, with me, Rawah al-Tabarani wal-Mundhari, he said, it's authentic hadith, min hadith Khuzaymah ibn Thabit, he said, اتقوا دعوة المظلوم فإنها تحمل على الغمام يقول الله وعزتي وجلالي لأنصرنك ولو بعد حين. Be careful to oppress people. If somebody make dua against you, Allah will give order to the cloud to carry this dua. And this dua will not go down anymore. Will go somehow to Allah. And Allah will say, Allah will swear by his power and dignity, he will make this dua, it will go through. يا جماعة, be careful, don't oppress anybody. That's why Allah said, وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبِّكَ إِذَا أَخَذَ الْقُرَى وَهِيَ ظَالِمَةٌ إِنَّ أَخْذَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ. when the villages, the people of the villages, they oppress, they make zulm against themselves, against others, Allah will punish them severely. He said that. Also, dear brothers, don't take the rights of others like what they say, what I just explained. These are some of the bad deeds can cause people to have a bad ending or bad death. Su' al-khatima, they call it in Arabic. Su' al-khatima. Tomorrow, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, we'll talk about the grave and we'll talk about the mujibat azab al-qabr. Why azab al-qabr? Why the punishment of the grave? And what kind of good deeds? I'm sorry, good deeds? No, good deeds, you will be rewarded in your grave. What kind of bad deeds will cause a person to be punished in his grave? It's good to say these things because we have to be aware of that, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Jazakum Allah khair. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from you all. Just try to come early, inshallah, 9 o'clock we start. Inshallah, don't miss these halaqat, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair.